The Super Bowl is the biggest single game event in American sports, but collectively, no event draws more action in Vegas and sportsbooks around the country than March Madness. Roughly $8 to $10 billion were wagered on March Madness in 2019, and it's likely this year will top that number. So if you want to throw down, which direction should you go? Gonzaga is the clear-cut favorite to win it all, but you'll only be making double your money.
When you look at those teams that went into the NCAA tournament, you know, undefeated, I mean, that's quite a group, and it's an honor to be associated with all of them.
The other one seeds Baylor, Michigan, and Illinois all next in line, and we'll get you bigger return on your investment.
But you now know your opponent. You're going to play Hartford. That's going to be a Friday game.
Once this interview's over, I'm going to ask you for all their secrets.
But beyond the one seeds is where the real money can be made. All four two seeds to win it all are sitting around 20 to 1. Oklahoma State, meanwhile, as a four seed, will be a trendy team to ride behind Cade Cunningham, but will face a tough road to the Final Four. They currently sit at around 30 to 1 to win the whole thing. The madness is about to begin. Will we see a top-heavy Final Four, or will there be upsets looming on the horizon? Either way, this will be one of the most anticipated NCAA tournaments in recent memory.
Well, we're here for all your betting needs and ready to provide you with the 2021 NCAA Tournament Gambling Guide. Now remember, wagering on the big dance is different than wagering on a regular season matchup. The stakes are higher, the lines are sharper, but no fear, we have you covered. And we're going to find some value in these first four games as we welcome in our Wizard of Odds, Kenny White. So it's crazy that this is a first four matchup, UCLA facing off against Michigan State. I can't believe that that is the game that we're talking about right now. But something to keep an eye on, the Spartans went 9-18 against the spread, the worst mark in the field. So Kenny, Michigan State, the favorites here, what's your best bet?
Yeah, Jenny, it is hard to believe that we are talking about these two programs in a play-in game. But Michigan State, you mentioned the ATS record. That was from a 4-15 start to the year. They did finish up 5-3 to end the season. Josh Langford moved to point guard. They played much better basketball. They couldn't seem to put really two good games back to back. But this is a Michigan State team that is far better on the defensive end than UCLA. They've also beaten three top 10 teams, Illinois, Ohio State, and Michigan. UCLA, their best win, number 43, Arizona. The average team in the Big Ten is better than anybody in the Pac-12. So a far better conference, strength of schedule. Michigan State played the eighth most difficult schedule in the entire country. UCLA, number 55. I think this is Sparty win by 8 to 10 points in this one.
So we're talking ATS. We have Drake and Wichita State up next. It's the opposite situation here than the Spartans. Drake at 21-6 against the spread is tied for the best record against the spread of any team in this tournament. So what do you think here? I think over-under set at 141.
Yeah, Drake was having a dream season, and their coach, Darren DeRise, he's going to be a big headliner somewhere. He's going to get a big job. He's done a tremendous success with this program. The problem with Drake, they lost a couple of players early in 2010. Or 2021, Tank Hemphill went down with an injury, and then they lost their point guard, Roman Penn. Tank Hemphill will be back for this game, but he's been out for such an extended period of time, and he's not an offensive threat, doesn't shoot three-pointers. He's an inside guy that does play good defense. That'll be a benefit. The line has moved 3.5 points from Wichita, a two-point favorite, to Drake, 1.5 because of Hemphill coming back. But it's always difficult your first game back. I think Wichita State has the team to beat Drake. They're a better defensive basketball team. They beat Houston this year, one of the best teams in the country, and they also only lost by 7 at Houston. So Wichita, I think, is a more talented team. They played a better schedule. I think they win this game. I think the money right now is on the wrong side. It's all coming in on Drake, and I think you're going to see that continue to move. I think Drake right now at 1.5 will go to 2, and then 2.5 at tip-off. But I'm taking the Shockers.
Yeah, the Shockers, their 16th NCAA tournament appearance and 8 in the last 9 years. So up next, we got Mount St. Mary's versus Texas Southern. This is expected to be a close one like all the other games. What's the best play here?
Yeah, this is two lower conference teams playing each other. Always difficult to predict these type of games. I'm going to go with the team who played in the better conference. The Northeast Conference, the average team was 8 points better than a SWAC team. So much better strength of schedule that Mount St. Mary's has played. They also play better defense. Mount St. Mary's plays at a very methodical pace. where Texas Southern wants to get up and down and have a crazy up and down pace. Mount St. Mary's isn't going to buy into that, and I think that will affect Texas Southern. They're not used to playing half-court basketball, and that's what this game's going to turn out to be. So I'll take Mount St. Mary's here.
All right. The final first four, we have Norfolk State facing off against Appalachian State. The Mountaineers are the favorites here. What do you like in this one?
Trying to figure out how to pronounce it. Is it Norfolk or Norfolk State? I don't know.
Norfolk? I don't know.
So I'm gonna go with the total anyway. It's an Appalachian State or Appalachian State. This is gonna be a game, I think, of pace because of Norfolk State. They play pressure defense. They force you into early shots, and I don't think that'll be a problem. App State plays very methodical, but they will have to go because of the pressure defense, and they shoot a lot of threes. So it's gonna come down. Can Appalachian State make those threes in this game? They shoot. They're 38th in the country in percentage of shots are three-pointers. They jack up a lot of threes. They've only played three teams this year that play at a fast pace: Louisiana, Georgia State, and Coastal Carolina. And in those games they played those teams, the median score was 148 points in those games. We're going over a total of 133 in this one.
Are you ready to take us region by region? So we're going to get into it now. Let's start in the West. The Zags obviously coming in perfect, 26-0. They're the odds-on favorites. So can they do it? What's your best bet in the West?
Yeah, in the history of college basketball in the tournament, only once has all four number one seeds made the finals. I think that was 2008. So you know you're going to get some upsets. You can't pick all number ones. But this is a number one I'm taking. The Zags are the real deal. I have them 4.5 points better than any college basketball team in the country. I think that's the biggest difference I've had ever in college basketball. So they are by far the best team. They play defense. They're outstanding on offense. They're in all phases of the game. This is a great team. They come in undefeated. I think they get to the Final Four. So they are, I think, the best bet at -$2. And I'll tell everybody, Jenny, on future bets are a convenience for you. So you can make the bet once and not have to look back. But you've got to remember that whoever you're betting with, your sports book, there is a theoretical hold built in. And those theoretical holds could be anywhere from 30 to 50%. On a straight bet, when you're betting one game, that it's a 4.5% theoretical hold. So if you like somebody in these brackets, you will get almost three times those odds by betting game to game and rolling your money over. But on the Zags, I think if you did that, the best you could probably get is -$1.25. So for the convenience, I don't mind laying $2 on Gonzaga on this one.
That's a really good point. So in some sense, just it's better off to wait. That you're teaching me a lot here today. All right, so we're gonna head over to the East now. You'll find Michigan on the one line. Some great round one matchups here. The SEC champs facing off against Patino. You got UConn going up against the Big Ten in Maryland. What's your best bet in the East region?
Yeah, this is going to be a fun region. Shame Michigan lost Isaiah Livers at the end of the year. He's a 3.5 point player, so it really drops their chances of winning at all. There's talented teams. LSU's looked good at down the run. Texas has looked good. But the team I'm going to go with at 14-1 is Connecticut. And I like Connecticut for several reasons. Dan Hurley's done a really good job with this team in teaching defense. And that's one thing I look for. I've got to have a good coach that his team plays defense. They also have a star player in James Bocknight. And I think that's going to be the difference in this round. I think Connecticut beats up on Maryland, who I think was a little phony this year and caught some breaks in the Big Ten because of letdowns. I think they're going to beat Alabama. I like Alabama. Loved them all year. I thought they were the best team in the SEC. But I think Connecticut, if they would have played in the SEC, would have been the best team in the SEC. So I think it's Connecticut and Michigan in the finals. And I think Connecticut wins at 14-1.
As a Connecticut girl, I appreciate that pick. We're going to move over to the South now. Baylor is the top seed, but it's been a tough couple of weeks for the Bears. Ohio State has shown what they're capable of. I've heard a lot of great things about Texas Tech and their coaching staff. Kenny, give me something good in the South.
Well, it's a team I've been touting all year long, and they have yet to put it all together. But I think they have everything it takes, what I look for in a tournament team. I like an experienced team. I like a team that shoots free throws. I like a team that plays defense. I like a team that doesn't turn it over. And that team is Wisconsin. I've been on them all year long. When I rated them out at the beginning of the year, I had them the fifth best team in college basketball. They haven't lived up to that once yet. But now they're in a different scenario. The back is to the wall now. They can't lose a game. I think you're going to see the best Wisconsin team you've seen. They have five seniors in their top seven rotation. They're one of the top 15 teams defensively. They're an excellent free throw shooting team. And they're second best team in the country in taking care of the basketball. They don't turn it over. North Carolina struggled to get in the tournament. They were life or death to get in. They were on the bubble. Wisconsin's going to beat them, and then they're going to beat Baylor. I think Wisconsin could end up beating Purdue and then Ohio State and getting to the Final Four, and they're 20-1. I think to win it all, you can get about 80-1. But again, if you bet Wisconsin game by game, Jenny, I think you could get them more at about 60-1 to win the South, and maybe about 200-1 to win it all.
Wisconsin, one of five schools to appear in 21 of the last 22 NCAA tournaments. Kenny, you said it, experience does matter, especially in a tournament like this. All right, last but not least, we're going to go to the Midwest, Illinois in that one spot. But in that field, you've got some of the most complete players and teams. We're talking Cade Cunningham, you got Sister Jean. She's cleared to attend the tourney. So this is a very tough region. Give us your best bet there.
Yeah, Loyola, the NCAA selection committee did not do them any favors whatsoever. I have Loyola ranked 19th in the country. They should have been a 4 or 5 seed. And now they got to play a hot Georgia Tech team. That was one team I really wanted to bet on with Sister Jean's team. But I can't because that's too tough of a draw. They got to play the Illini the second game. For the odds, again, and the convenience, the Illini would be my pick just conveniently. But if you want to play Houston, and that's who I like, if you bet Houston on the money line, their four games, you'll get more about 5.5-1 or 11-2 on your money, or 6-1, depending on how big of a favorite or small of an underdog they are in the championship game against Illinois. So Houston would be my most value by betting game to game. Conveniently right now, the odds at William Hill, the one that has the most value is that Illini team who has two NBA players, two first round NBA players on their roster with Io and Colburn. So that's going to be a really good team. They're battle tested because of the conference they're in. They're going to have a battle though against Loyola in the second round because that's, you know, state bragging rights, and Loyola is that good. But I think the Illini are better in the end, and they will get there to the championship game against Houston, and I'll have both teams going for me at that point.
And it's crazy to think it's their first NCAA tournament appearance since 2013 for the Fighting Illini. But hey, you're really big on the Big Ten. I love that. Before we let you go, I need to hear your pick for the national championship. Who you got?
Yeah, odds-wise, again, 35 to 40% are built into these odds. So you can get 2 to 3 times these numbers just by betting games singly, hand to hand. But the one team I don't think you can is Gonzaga. They're going to be in the Final Four. And they're going to be a favorite in their first game in the Final Four. As I mentioned, I am 4.5 points better than any team in college basketball. So in the semifinal game, they could be a 6 or 7 point favorite and then a 4.5 point favorite in the championship game. So I think they're the best team in the country by far. And I think there's value with them at +$2. I hate to pick a favorite. But again, there's other teams that I'm going to play, Connecticut and Wisconsin, to win it all. But at the odds right now that they're giving me conveniently, it's not going to be worth it to me. I'd rather bet them game by game, and you got a 6-team parlay. Connecticut will pay more like 40-1, and Wisconsin, as I said, will pay 200-1.
You're not the only one. This is a very chalky bracket, I feel like, this year. The last number one overall seed to win it all was Louisville in 2013. A lot of people picking the Zags to do that once again. Kenny, thank you so much for sharing your wealth of knowledge with us here on the queue as we take a little recap into the games. Kenny said it earlier, the last time all 4-1 seeds made the Final Four was 2008. That was the only time it's happened in the history of tournaments. So listen to our man Kenny and his best bets. And if you need more, you got to join Jonathan Coachman and the crew, like our man Kenny White, on the Early Edge podcast. The best part, it's only 10 minutes and in your feed every single day by 11 a.m. The 49ers keep their guy, Trent Williams, making history with his contract there. Our NFL insider Jonathan Jones tells us about that. What is the next step for the 49ers? Are we going to see another big move? That's next.
Want a sports network that delivers everything that matters about the game? The highlights, the picks, the instant analysis. No yelling, no fake debates, no politics. Hit the subscribe button and never miss a moment.